Egypt spirit of a warrior is alive and happening. And coming up next, the one we've all been waiting for, Ong Lan Sung puts the middleweight strap on the line for the first time against Ken Hasegawa, the deep megaton champion who's overcome his struggles.
ちょうど試合前に首のヘルニアが出てきてて、うまく手も動かなくなったんですよ。もうなんか死にたいみたいな、なんで俺ここにいるんだろうって、何すればいいんだろうって、毎日本当になんかこう首の怪我で3キロのものも持てない状態になって、生活も普通にできないわけじゃないですか。格闘技もできないし、そんななんかどん底の状況で、もう結構人に会うのも嫌だったんですけど、僕の場合はすごく周りに恵まれてるって言ったのかな。周りの人が引っ張ってくれたりとか、周りの人が僕が乗り越えやすいように助けてくれたりすることが多かったんで、へこんだ時も落ち込んだ時、どん底に落ちた時も立ち直れたんで、周りの支えがあったからここまで来れたからかなって。
Ken Hasegawa makes his way along the hallway of champions for the very first time. The third degree black belt in judo, the deep megaton champion is going after the gold of Ong Lan Sung.He's going to take on Ong La and 55 million in Ong La's corner.
Buddy, you're a big night, big night, big night, big night.
Approach. He likes to get people down. When he does choose to take you down, get on top, mount you, and then just pound on you, submit you from a lot of different areas. He's a very, very talented young man.
Hasegawa starts explosively. He has stopped his opponent in 10 of his 16 wins in the very first round. 6 wins by knockout, 4 with punches, 2 with kicks.6-0 record in bouts that have gone the distance. Known for having quick, compact strikes for a heavier athlete, he takes on the darling, the national hero of Myanmar, the one and only Ong Lan Sung.
not to like be prideful and anything like that, but it's overwhelming, like how much attention I get. It's also motivating for me, but it's hard for a person, you know, who sees me on an everyday basis to understand that. When I walk around the street, people want to take a picture with me. People from all these, you know, groups want to meet with me and, you know, talk to me. My role has certainly changed. I take it as a blessing. It's a chance for me to promote positivity. People really look up to my work and what I've done, you know, so it's a time in my life where I have to be less selfish and more giving.
Ong Long Song makes his way down the hallway of champions tonight. The greatest star in all of Myanmar puts his world middleweight title on the line. This place is about to go bananas. They are about to have a meltdown for their national superhero, Ong Long Song. Look at the intensity. Look at the focus. Look at the determination.
World champion, Ong Ah! Ian Cartwright of Canada, Jonathan Lai of Canada, and Rosenberg Rossetti from the Philippines. Myanmar, here we go! Introducing first, out of the blue corner, he is a deep openweight champion, standing at 181 centimeters tall, holding a record of 16 wins and 2 losses. Representing Japan, give it up for the challenger, Ken Hasegawa. And now, introducing his opponent out of the red corner. He is a Myanmar national hero, standing at 185 centimeters tall, holding a record of 22 wins and 10 losses. Training out of Hard Knocks 365, representing Myanmar! Presenting to you the one middleweight and light heavyweight world champion, your referee in charge, Mr. Olivier Coast.
I want a team fair fight. Then go if you want it by your corner.
On instructions from Olivier Coast. There's nothing quite like it. The moment before an Aung San Suu world title match against his toughest opponent yet. In Ken Hasegawa, Michael Cervello, Mitch Chosunwiki. Main event from Yangon, Myanmar. It's one championship. Aung San Suu, tremendous power in his roundhouse kicks, in his punches. So too, the thickly built Ken Hasegawa.
Aung San looks very intense, while Hasegawa looks very relaxed.
A new training camp for Aung San Suu in Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
The right hand of Aung San Suu snuck right through the guard.
Right roundhouse kick from Aung San Suu. Hasegawa, the deep megaton, open weight champion. Comes here very well credentialed. To left hand there from Ken Hasegawa. Omar showing patience, edges forward as the champion. Probing with the jab out of southpaw stance, Ken Hasegawa. Jab to the cross there from Hasegawa, just falls short for the Japanese martial artist. Outside leg kick misses the target from Aung San Suu. Second one connects for Onlar.
He's like, I was starting to find a home for that left hand. He's trying to gauge the distance as he's cutting through the guard of Onlar. Right there, just landed again.
The left drops, the power drops of the southpaw from Japan. Body shot off the lead hand from Onlar. Onlar, two-punch combination, grazing with the left. Goes to southpaw stance, Onlar.
Onlar's landed a few times, though, but Hasegawa's wearing it well.
Jab there from Aung San Suu. Switches back to orthodox stance now. There's the champion. Hasegawa threads the high left roundhouse kick.
Nice little combination from Hasegawa. Left hand, left kick.
Going to change levels perhaps, mix it up a little here. Ken Hasegawa almost circles into that right roundhouse kick. The roundhouse kick that knocked out Machado. Fake there from Aung San Suu. Thought about throwing the right hand down the tube. Reset from center cage. Left cross falls short for Hasegawa. An intriguing half a round down so far. Roundhouse kick to the upper left ribs there from Aung San Suu.
These guys are very similar, like they have very almost duplicate styles, like they're going against a mirror. They've got the same jab straight combination, same big roundhouse kick coming off the rear leg.
Every time on the lands, this crowd goes crazy. A sellout again inside the mighty Toronto Indoor Stadium. Hasegawa had some fire on the lead hand. Both men showing tremendous respect for the capabilities of one another. Plenty of instruction coming from the corners. Ola gets out of the way of the two-punch combo. Hasegawa resets. The southpaw from Japan. Oh, the right hand! Smack bang! Smack bang! First real power salvo from Ono and Sun. And Hasegawa rallies back. Ono applying the pressure, coming forward. Hasegawa locking eyes with the champion. Step through knee, and Hasegawa backs him off with the right hand. Both men showing some terrific boxing so far here, Mitch.
These are big middleweights putting a lot of power behind these heavy hands.
Hasegawa, a game opponent with 25 seconds on the clock.
Hasegawa competing against one of the best middleweights in the world, the best middleweight in the world, but he's also got these 10,000 Myanmar fans against him as well.
And we are told that one in every three of this country of 55 million is watching live, watching their hero, Ong Lan Sun, defend the middleweight world title.
Take a look at some of Ong Lan's shots here. Look at that. He caught a kick. Right hand on the chin, and then he got hit with a kick. That was the best combination of Ken Hasegawa, but Ong Lan comes right back with a nice overhand right of his own. Back and forth action, very close first round.
Wherever you're watching in 138 countries around the world, or live on the One Super App, we hope you're enjoying all the madness, all the mayhem, all the martial arts magnificence. That is one championship from Yangon, Myanmar. The middleweight world title of that match. Ong Lan Sun is on the line. He's a two-division champion.
Some wise words coming off of Henry Hooft, the head coach for Ong Lan Sun, as he tells him he wants to make sure that he covers up a little bit better, make sure he keeps his hands nice and tight.
Round two. Second round set for five. We're seeing a fantastic toe-to-toe matchup so far. Roundhouse kick to the ribs there from Ong Lan. Thumping right hand down the center corridor from the champion. Hasegawa backs him off with the lead hand. Power in both hands of the southpaw.
Hasegawa starting to march forward. Trying to put punches together in bunches.
Ong Lan's got to keep that left hand up because the right lead of Hasegawa is finding the mark.
That's what Henry Hoof told him. He said he wants to keep his hands nice and close to his chin. A little bit of a slip there from Ong Lan.
A very humid atmosphere inside Toronto Indoor Stadium. Online side, looks to get on the inside. Hasegawa almost walked into that rising knee.
Hasegawa starting to push forward a bit more on his boxing. Cutting a little bit of angles. This is typically what we see from Ong Lan. Ong Lan likes to pivot out to the right and left very well.
A hook to a left cross there.
Look at the welt starting to develop on Hasegawa's left rear.
It is purple and deep red from the roundhouse kicks off the back leg of Ong Lan Sun. Hasegawa fight. Ong Lan fires out a front kick. Hasegawa Those booming chants go up again for Ong Lan San. He drops one down to the belly button. Asagawa threads the left cross nicely. He's got a bit of pepper behind it. Ong Lan looks to close the gap. Stumbles backwards, clips him with a short right hook.
Looks like that caught him off balance though as Ong Lan stumbles backwards and a nice left or right hand from Asagawa.
Asagawa again, a popping jab. Takes another rib kick. Asagawa's got some fire in his hands. Ong Lan taking his time, not overextending himself, not rushing. A cerebral performance from the champion. Jab cross combo there from the challenger. The cross lands again, but he didn't have the torque. He didn't turn into it. Toe to toe. Asagawa comes forward, straight line punches. A high right roundhouse kick from Ong Lan. Asagawa backs him off with another cross. Ong Lan takes two, solid blows to the jaw. Got to keep the hands up the champion. This is a good boxing spell here, Mitch, from the challenger.
And Hasegawa's really putting his punches together nicely. He's finding the home, he's finding that range with his jab, and his counter strike is looking clean. Very good round so far for Hasegawa.
Hasegawa.
Burmese Python has a really good guillotine, so Hasegawa's got to be careful, make sure he keeps his head high on that entry.
Edges forward again, does the check. Ong Lan San, second round set for five for the world middleweight title clash. Little dippy body shot at the right hand there from Ong Lan. Flips him with a left hook. Body shot from Ong Lan. Throws out the front kick. What a battle we are seeing for the world title. Ong Lan, right hand lead. Asagawa threads a right hand of his own, that being the lead hand of the southpaw.
In those close distance exchanges, that's Hasegawa's best time. He's trying to catch Ong Lan, and Ong Lan's trying to use that.
Asagawa cuts on the side of the right eye.
Ooh, nice hook, straight combo.
Asagawa jab two, follows through with another right hand. There's the jab to right of his own, and Asagawa now toe to toe. Ong Lan goes to the body, Asagawa goes to the jaw. Back and forth action to close out the second round. This crowd in Yangon, and I'm sure around the world, loving every moment of this world title match. And there's one of our luminaries, heavyweight superstar Alan Galani, here cape side.
And who's the other guy? Paul Ta, another Myanmar superstar. Look at this action. Watch this. Ong Lan tries to come up the middle with an uppercut just as Hasegawa attacks that low leg, sweeps it out from under him, creating a slight stumble from the champion. Hasegawa comes marching forward, throws two punches. Ong Lan fades out of the way. Boom, comes back with one of his own. The back and forth action is just tremendous as Hasegawa lands a big right hook.
Fantastic back and forth action. Both men landing heavy shoulders. The handiwork of Hasegawa in the second round. But there's a good look at the cut in a very dangerous spot.
Round
and there's
three.
Another champion as he defends the crown. Third round of five.
Little mouse under the eye of the champion. Little cut under the eye of the challenger. Third round, here we go.
And sweat flies off the brow of both as they both land punches. There's it. Flipping overhand left out of southpaw starts from Ong Lan. Asagawa backs him off the left hand. A beautiful left hook there from Asagawa. A double jab from the Japanese challenger. Oh, left kick. The headache maker.
reverberated all throughout the stadium.
Hasegawa back to the front floor. Now it's all over the top.
Look for him to drop elbows and try to crucifix.
Unlearned Sang back to his feet, drills a body shot. This crowd is crazy. Uppercut from Unlearned. Hasegawa tags him. Looks for the uppercut again. A downward elbow. A crossing elbow. Hasegawa does a quick count of his teeth. Goes to the body, trying to soften up the midsection. Hasegawa breathing heavy. There's a huge mouse swelling up the right eye of Unlearned Sang. Uppercut from the champion.
The challenger's mouth is wide open, but he's still coming forward. Unlearned wisely starts to go to the body.
This is like something out of a Hollywood movie. Back and forth, a slugfest. A solid left cross there from Hasegawa. Unlearned throws a roundhouse kick. The champ comes forward again. A bolo punch from the champion. A body rip to the liver. Hasegawa to the head. Corner to much more. This is guts. An intestinal fortitude personified. Both men letting it all hang out. They're pulling out all the stops.
Both guys have bit down on their mouthpiece and are just throwing hands.
This is what they came to see. This is pure theater. A right hand lands from Unlearned Sang. A wild looping left. He's in southpaw stance for Chan. Hasegawa backs him off. Hasegawa's hands around his waist. This is epic. This is awesome.
The left eye of Unlearned starting to swell shut. Hasegawa's marching forward, landing shots.
What a show. A spinning backfist attempt from Hasegawa. Here it comes. Unlearned Sang. He tags him with a right hand again. What more have they got left in the tank? These two incredible martial artists. Toe to toe again. They're giving it their all. This is one for the ages. Unlearned goes to the body.
Michael, and this is the third round. 40 seconds left as Unlearned marches forward with a big stick right down.
Both of Unlearned's eyes are smiling now. Still the champ comes forward, goes to the sternum, backs up the challenger. What about a clinch and knee? 20 seconds remain in the third round as Hasegawa lands across to the jaw. Jab from the challenger. Jab two. This has been amazing. The atmosphere, the battle, the moment.
I like how Unlearned starting to go to the body. He's mixing it up. Hasegawa is just headhunting. Unlearned attacking the body just as much as he's attacking the head. Take a look at some of this action. There was a big exchange, but then the counter off the right hands, but then Unlearned landed a sneaky uppercut with his right. Constant action from these two as they go toe to toe, back and forth, just landing big punches. Now, Michael, this is unseen territory. for the challenger, Ken Hasegawa. He has never been into the championship rounds. He has never needed to see a fourth and fifth, and Ongla lives in deep water.
But look at the damage on Ongla's face, a sight we never see. Both eyes are swollen, also the damage on Ken Hasegawa. This has been something extraordinary. Fourth round, the penultimate round. They call these the championship round. It is one championship from Yangon, Myanmar, and it is a blockbuster. The cage door closes. Ongla's
round
stolen shot. And Hasegawa, as Mitch said, has to dig deep, has to go to a place inside of himself that he's never been to before. This is when it becomes more than physical. And Hasegawa shoots in. Ongla stops the takedown.
And Ongla is trying to transition to the back. Hasegawa caught it. The mouth guard goes out.
Knees to the ribs. That'll make it even harder. Hasegawa wobbling around the cage. How much more does the Tiger have left? It has been an absolute beauty, a rip snorter. Ongla with the right hand, the body shots. Hasegawa tags him with the left cross. Hasegawa again. Both these men, more punch than a high school prom. There's a right hand from Ongla, there's a stiff uppercut. It's all boxing now. They're fighting on spirit. Spirit, and they've got to dig deep down into that well of intestinal fortitude. What have they got? What is keeping them going?
What's keeping Ongla going is this crowd. This is when the crowd is going to lift you and drive you, because you're competing for something bigger than yourself. You're competing for all these thousands of people that are rooting you on.
Surviving.
This is insane. The left hand from Ugla's son.
One hook goes in. Ugla might take the back with 30 seconds to go.
Can Hasegawa survive the round? Ugla's son tries to get the second hook in to no avail. It's a turtle shell here from Hasegawa. Olivia Post having a look at Hasegawa's face. In here, you can feel it. Every hair in your body is tingling. One more round to go. And what is one championship epicness?
Oh, the law looks wobbled, but Ken Hasegawa looks the worst of the two. But wow, look at this grappling exchange right here. Hasegawa continues to push forward. Plus, sprawls out very heavy, gets control there in the clinch, throws a knee to the body as the mouthpiece goes down. Here was how they finished the round. Ugla rolls into the rear naked choke. Looks like he's face cranking there. The choke's not in, it's a face crank. Hasegawa defends the hooks very well, still aware, completely aware of his surroundings, able to scramble back up on top, and then to finish with Ugla on top. What a match!
One more round to go. Will Hasegawa crack? Or has he got the turbo to put the foot down in the business end in the final round? Amazing scenes. There are matches across all sports that go down in history as simply unforgettable. This is one of them. This is unforgettable. And look at the sportsmanship. Look at the martial arts code of honor. Hasegawa is seeing out of one eye.
Hasegawa's got to keep his guard up. That right eye is almost swollen shut as Ugla marches forward as he's looking the fresher of the two.
Both men throwing punches. A gripping left hand there from Ugla's son and sends the mouth guard of Hasegawa flying.
That's a risky run when your mouth hangs open like that. One well-placed punch and your mouthpiece will pop out.
Hasegawa jabs, backs off the champion with the left cross. Anything can happen. In the sport of champions in milliseconds, spin it back over. The inner left way of Ugla's son coming out on that occasion. A curling lead hand from the challenger. Backs up the champion again. Ugla dances out of trouble. Goes to the body. Hasegawa misses with a lead uppercut. The crowd on the edge of their seats. In fact, most of them here are standing. Their national hero, Ugla's son. The most famous man in Myanmar. 3:20 away from possibly retaining his championship. We said Hasegawa on paper was his toughest opponent ever. Certainly that has been the case. Ugla puts all his stuff behind the right hand. A jab and a southpaw stance.
What a beautiful trip takedown as Ugla gets on top. Hasegawa is defending the hooks. And he can't let Ugla wrap his legs around his body, but he gets back up.
Hasegawa defends. He's back to his feet. Almost halfway through the round. A jab from the champion. A cross and a jab from the arm heavy challenger. On Hasegawa, extraordinary victory ability. Ugla resets, goes to the midsection of the lead hand, eats a nice stiff jab from Hasegawa. Ugla switches. clock starts. Under 2 minutes remaining. A knee to the midsection from the champion. Thrust out a jab. Body shots.
After a match like that, is there anything you can't do?
We'll find out, but I promise you guys, I'm gonna work hard. I'm not happy with this performance. I go back to training next week. I wanna be the best. I wanna be the best of the best middleweight in the world. Let's go!
Myanmar, show your and light hair.